think the other big takeaway for me in this game was just how deep A&M is at the running back spot, not even including Leon Moss, who committed early this week and is not one of the top backs in the 2022 class. You look at just the options that they're going to have next year, even losing a guy like Isaiah Spiller, a guy like Amari Daniels is right there waiting, quick, decisive, was able to get the edge. And in some ways, I think he has a little bit of, he doesn't have the speed, and not many do, that a guy like Devon Achane does, but a guy that can get on the edge and has that sort of burst was one of the big things for me. I think in the carries that he's gotten this year, I know it's been limited roles, but I thought he's really showed some good things, and sometimes isn't talked about as much. You know, LJ Johnson gets talked about quite a bit, and thought he had some good runs today. He seems to be more of a one cut guy and find the hole and get through. But you know, that running back room is in really good shape for A&M moving forward. And even a guy like Yo'Keith Brown, how about him? One carry today and takes it 45 yards down the sideline. I thought he had a good day, showed some things, especially on special teams, showed some good things. And then you even get, you know, Jalen Preston more involved. And so this, the depth of this team is certainly something that's notable on both sides of the ball. And there were also a lot of younger players playing on the defensive side. And then, you know, they're going to have to replace a lot on that side of the ball heading into next year. Thought Isaiah Rakes did some good things. Adrian Cooper continues to be super, super impressive. And how about Antonio Johnson, the year that he has put together, to lose the big hit during the first quarter that leads to a score for Aaron Hansford? Thought he had another really, really good day. And he's going to be a name to watch next year. And when the spotlight will kind of be on him coming off the year that he's put together, just a great year. He's really stepped forward into a much bigger role. And so I think that was the encouraging thing in the second half, and something Jimbo Fisher really talked about. He was not pleased with the way his team finished the game against New Mexico, and just the attention to detail, the sharpness. But that was a completely different story this afternoon. A lot of long drives in the second half, even if it didn't result in a score like the one with the interception, you still had a 5-play drive, a 12-play, 74-yard drive, and then a couple tough drives to end the game. But a lot to like there, and that's what you want to see when those guys get opportunities, and some of those young linemen be able to move guys and show that they're making progress heading into the offseason. Especially along the offensive line, that was, I think, one of the big concerns heading into this year was just the depth. What sort of depth did A&M have along the offensive line? And I think those guys have steadily improved heading into the final game of the year and heading into the offseason. There'll be some options heading into next year with a lot more guys getting experience. Again, really liked what I saw from Trey Zun, and it's good to see him healthy again. Was a really, really good addition to the class and just unfortunately got hurt last fall, so wasn't really an option coming into the year. Jordan Moko is still a guy that's going to be a bit of a project, but good to get him a playing experience. He hasn't played a lot of football, so, you know, a game like this where you can get him in the second half is a tremendous opportunity for a guy still learning the game. To get him in a right guard with his strength and his power was tremendous. So overall, really good afternoon and pretty much what you were looking for if you're an A&M fan was to come out and take care of business in stress-free fashion, and now can turn the focus to next week. Again, LSU on the road to close out the regular season at 6 p.m. That game will be on ESPN, I believe, in Baton Rouge, and we'll have a post-game show after that one as well. And